My dear friends, welcome to Rajasekhar classes on applied data science with Python. This is lecture number 214. In this lecture, we will try to understand circle, sphere, and hypersphere. It is simple lecture. If you speak strictly, it is an elementary class lecture. Since we learned about line, I already discussed about line. Now let's learn about other structures like circle, sphere, which we studied in high school. We learn about a circle in 2D, in two-dimensional space. You might have seen circle like this, isn't it? It's 2D, and equivalent concept in 3D or higher dimensions. What are those equivalent concepts? We will try to understand. Let's understand 2D. Let's assume I have two axes, x-axis as well as y-axis. For simplicity, let me call them as x equal to x1 and another one y equal to x2. Isn't it? For my convenience, just I am assuming like this. Let's assume, what is the center of this circle? Center of the circle is 0, 0. Is the center of the circle. Let's assume the radius of the circle is r. R is the radius of the circle. In the equation of the circle, any point lying on the circle can be written as x square plus y square equal to r square. It is a circle whose center is 0, 0 and radius is r. Here remember, the center of the circle is the origin. If the center of the circle is not origin and something else, let's assume my center of the circle is h, k. How can I write circle equation with center h, k? Just see this one. This is simple circle whose center is h, k and radius is r. Therefore, this circle equation is x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square equal to r square. This is the equation of the circle with center h comma k and radius r, isn't it? And the radius r, just for simplicity. Let's assume a point, let's assume a point P x1 comma x2. Now, I can determine whether this P is inside the circle or outside the circle or on circumference of the circle. Actually, a circle also separates your region in 2D space into two regions, isn't it? Inside the circle is one region and outside the circle is another region. So given any point Px1, x2, if I just take any point x1, x2 and substitute in x square plus y square equal to r square, if this x1 square plus x2 square is less than r square, this point P, I can say point P lies, in, what is my circle equation? Let me assume my circle equation is x square plus y square equal to r square. This is a circle with center 0, 0 and radius r. For simplicity, I am considering a circle with center 0, 0. Now, if I keep this x1, x2 in this equation, if x1 square plus x2 square is less than r square, I can say this point P lies inside the circle. That you must understand. It must be inside the circle, isn't it? Now the circle, if x1 square plus x2 square is greater than r square, then I can say P lies outside the circle. P lies outside the circle, isn't it? Outside the circle. If x1 square plus x2 square equal to r square, then I can say P is on the circumference of the circle. It is satisfying on the circumference of the circle. It is simple observation from our high school standard. Of course, these simple observations are also useful in our data science, so that I am discussing. Let's move on to slightly what happens in 3D. 3D means what? There are three axes, let me say, x1, x2, x3, isn't it? There are these three, I have three dimensions. If I have if I have circular sphere, the equation of the circle in 3D sphere means your 2D is extending to 3D, means that is sphere. You can say if there are three axes, how many axes are there? This is x1 axis, this is x2 axis, this is x3 axis, means what is the sphere equation? x1 square plus x2 square plus x3 square equal to r square. This is sphere whose center is origin and the radius is r. In similar manner, you can extend this one to n-dimensional space. How can I write in n dimensions? This is 3D, isn't it? This one is 3D. What about nd? If it is nd in n-dimensional space, I can write x1 square plus x2 square plus so on xn square is equal to r square. This is the equation of the hypersphere. I can say this is the equation of the hypersphere, isn't it? Whereas this is equation of sphere. In 3D sphere, in nd, that is hypersphere, isn't it? This can be written as x1 square plus x2 square plus so on xn square equal to r square can be written as sigma I equal to 1 to n xi square is equal to r square. This is the equation of the hypersphere, just like 2D, 3D, nd. In the case of nd also, if sigma I equal to 1 to n, just if I substitute a point, sigma I, let me rewrite otherwise, let me say I have a point P. What is my point P? x1, x2, so on, let me say it is xn. Now I must check whether this point P lies inside the hypersphere or outside the hypersphere. It is simple. Sigma I equal to 1 to n, xi square is less than r square. Means x1 square plus x2 square plus so on x1 square is less than r square. If it is the case, I can say then P is inside the hypersphere, isn't it? In similar analogy, hypersphere. In similar manner, if this is greater than r square, sigma I equal to 1 to n xi square is greater than r square, it must be outside hypersphere. It must be outside, isn't it? Outside of the hypersphere. If it is equal to r square, it is on the circumference. It must be on the circumference of the sphere. Hypersphere, if I speak strictly, that is on circumference of the hypersphere, isn't it? In similar manner, I can have ellipse. What is this ellipse? Ellipse can be equation of an ellipse. What is an equation of an ellipse? In 2D, I can say it is ellipse, isn't it? What about 3D? In 3D, we used to call it as ellipsoid, isn't it? Ellipsoid, I can say. Whereas it is in nd, in n-dimensional space, I can say hyper ellipsoid, isn't it? Now, what can I say? Those of you know, this is very, very simple idea called an ellipse. Ellipse, like, I can say it's something like egg-shaped structure. Egg-shaped thing, isn't it? Ellipse is just similar to egg shape. So, suppose, imagine, let's look at in 2D, what I have to do. Usually, we will extend discussions from 2D to 3D. Let's assume I have two dimensions, x1 and x2, isn't it? Let's also call x1 as x and x2 as y, isn't it? x2 as y. Let's assume center of the ellipse is origin. What is the center of this ellipse? This is origin. Origin is the center of the ellipse. This is called center. Center of the ellipse. Which one is major axis? This biggest one is major axis. This is major axis. This is major axis. The smallest one is, I can say it is minor axis. Depending on length, we used to call biggest one is major axis, whereas smallest one is known as minor axis. Equation of the ellipse. What is an equation of the ellipse? As usual, x square by a square plus y square by b square equal 1. This is an equation of the ellipse in 2D. An ellipse is also breaks up your 2D space into two regions. One is inside the ellipse and another one is outside the ellipse, isn't it? In machine learning, we don't use ellipses as much. We mostly use planes. Most extensively we use planes, but we also use sometimes circles, isn't it? If I substitute this x, I'm saying in the place of x1 I can write, in the place of x I can write x1. Let me assume this is x1 axis, this is x2 axis. Therefore, this equation can be written as x1 square by a square plus x2 square by b square equal to 1. As usual, if this particular value, which value? X1 square by a square plus x2 square by b square is less than 1, then I can say that particular point P x1 comma x2 is inside the ellipse. If it is greater than 1, it's outside the ellipse. If it is equal to 1, it must be on the circumference of the ellipse. This is my 2D. Now I can extend it into 3D. In the case of 3D, we used to call it as an ellipsoid. Literally, like your egg-shaped curve, isn't it? It is just, I imagine, three-dimensional egg-like structure. Just see, this is simple and straightforward structure. This is x1 square by a square plus x2 square by b square plus x3 square by c square is equal to 1. This is an equation of ellipsoid. As usual, if you take a point P x1, x2, x3 and keep in this equation, if it is less than 1, this particular point is inside. If inside that ellipse, if it is greater than 1, it must be outside of the ellipsoid. If it is equal to 1, it must be inside of the ellipsoid. I can extend this one to n-dimensional space. In the case of n-dimensional space, how can I write equation x1 square by a1 square, let me say, x2 square by a2 square I can write, so on I can write xn square by an square I can write, which is equal to 1. This is, I can say, n dimensional space. I can say this is hyper ellipsoid. A similar analogy can be applicable here also. If you keep some point P x1, x2, so on xn, if it is less than 1, it must be inside ellipsoid. If it is greater than 1, it must be outside the ellipsoid. If it is equal to 1, it must be on the ellipsoid. In similar manner, you can understand something like cuboids and hypercuboids. These simple structures are useful in future classes. Just try to understand equations. Again, I will discuss whenever and wherever it is required. Just go through it. Thank you very much. If you have any difficulty, just keep a comment. Thank you.